The concerns are contained in the December 2022 Auditor General's report, where auditors reviewed the total expenditure on the repair of the fleet of the judiciary to determine whether the funds were put to good use, and established that in 2021-2022 alone, 5.514 billion shillings was spent on vehicle repairs, which MP were not convinced with.
Judiciary spending a lot of money on repairing their vehicles, it doesn't indicate that they are having an old fleet. It might be new, but if someone wants money, it is very simple. He goes somewhere, they write an invoice, even when there is nothing they have worked on. Then you will pay. After paying, he will get his money from the mechanic or from the garage.
So since you cannot use a smaller car, the value of a smaller car to repair a bigger car, I think it is a sign of corruption, embezzlement, and misuse of government resources. For me, I would believe that if possible, these judicial officers and all government agencies would be publishing such garages which they use for repairing these vehicles, so that even a layman Ugandan, beside even the report for the Auditor General comes out, a layman Uganda can also visit those same garages and identify, finds out, determines the actual value for repair of machinery.
The Auditor General sampled 26 vehicles and observed that each vehicle visited the garage an average of 8 times in a year. Shockingly, the judiciary spent 26.486 million shillings on each vehicle as a cost of repair. Legislators claim the cost of repair is exaggerated, as it can buy another vehicle in local bonds.
They don't even need special inquiries. There is a need for arresting them and even impounding those vehicles and arrest them, put them into cells so that they can speak out reality.
Probably only 10 million has been spent on that car, and 16 has been stolen, either by the driver or by the person in charge of repairing. So it happens, even us, it happens to us. You go to a garage, a driver tells the mechanic that I want some money, some percentage out of the charges you are going to indicate. So it is happening everywhere. So we have to change the way we live.
Now some lawmakers want a deep investigation into the matter to establish value for money, saying 5 billion shillings is unrealistic.
We need to do a deep inquiry. But already the Auditor General has inquired, and that is the job of that office. So even if we go beyond, we shall discover the same thing. But what we have to do is to make sure that we encourage all Ugandans to change the way they behave.
The Secretary to the Judiciary, Pius Bijidimana, while appearing before the Public Accounts Committee, attributed the high cost of motor vehicle repairs on aging fleet, saying some judicial officers are using vehicles manufactured in 2005, contrary to the public standing orders that entitles government officials to new cars that should be disposed of after 5 years.
The concern was that the repairs were taking a lot of money, and our explanation was that the vehicles we have are very old.
But he assured the committee that the judiciary has procured new vehicles for most judicial officers, and the cost of repairs is expected to adjust accordingly.
That we have managed to procure some vehicles, and the repair bills are going to come down. In the subsequent submissions, certainly you will not be having these repair bills.
It should be remembered that the Minister of Finance announced a halt on procurement of new cars in the current financial year to save for ambulances. In February 2023, the judiciary requested a supplementary budget of over 5 billion shillings for the purchase of armored cars and provision of security to some judges, which was granted. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.